Export variables make your code less maintainable by putting dependencies into all of the files. But it's hard to argue that ability to edit values of fields straight from Godot editor's UI is very convenient. But what if I tell you that you can edit your fields from the editor while storing them in external database? How? In this video, we are going to implement a solution that lets you combine convenience and maintainability. If you missed previous videos in this series, I strongly recommend to check them out before continuing with this one. In these videos, I explained in details why we don't want to use export variables, and showed two solutions for storing all of your data in one file, where you can easily edit. We are also going to use features of tool keyword intensively in this video to reach our goal. So, if you aren't familiar with this keyword and tool mode in Godot, here's a video about it explaining what it is and how to work with it. What we are going to do today is quite straightforward. First of all, let's restore export keywords before our variables. This keyword is still going to write values of variables into the scene files, but using tool scripts, we are going to just override these values with those stored in our database. Therefore, our next step is to add a tool keyword to every script of our hierarchy and database script. After that, we just need to reopen a scene and it's already working. To some degree. It is resetting export variables to values that is stored in database every time we open this scene. Next step is to update our model every time we are changing one of the export variables. To do so, we have to add a setter to every export variable, which is first going to update value of this variable, and second it's going to call to a special function, which we are going to use for updating our model. We want to lock this behavior behind the editor hint check, to make sure that it won't trigger in-game for any reasons. After that, we are going to update our local model with values of local variables. But doing it that way clutters the code. Instead, let's define an array which will store names of variables which we want to keep track of. With this change, we can now iterate through all the variables in this for each loop, both when we want to extract it from the model and insert it back. Now that local model is up to date, we want to make changes to global model. Let's add a special method for that inside of DataScript. Good. Any changes from export variables now go straight to in-memory model. Next step is to save this model into our database file, which is quite easy with JSON. We have to call JSON print on our model, adding backslash t as second parameter for good looking formatting of resulting JSON. After that, save the string into file and model stored on hard drive is now synced with changes from export variables. But now that we close the loop, by which I mean the setting variable changes database, which then propagates new values, we are faced with a problem. Export variable still keeps its value inside of a scene file and sets this value back to variable when it initializes the scene, which happens through the same mechanism that we are using to set it from UI. Do you see where I'm going with this? Yes. When Godot sets this value, our setter gets called and updates the database with it. So, with this interaction, there is no way for importing external changes into the model. Gladly, all of this happens before any function of an object gets called, while all the code that we wrote to that moment works after or inside of any function. Thus, to fix the problem, all we have to do is to define a boolean variable, which is set to false by default, and set it to true inside of our ready function, then lock code that updates model behind this boolean. With this, we have a fully closed loop. We can update database from our UI, and update UI from database. But it's still very inconvenient, since it takes a full restart of the whole project to just propagate any external changes. Our last goal is to fix that. To do so, we obviously have to keep track of database stored on hard drive. We are going to use process function for that, but checking file every frame is quite expensive. So let's define constant portraying how often we want to check file, and variable for time. Now we can call for check of database periodically. For this check, we are going to add one more variable. It's going to store time when database was last edited. And of course, we have to update it when we try to read from database or when we write into it from the engine. With all of that done, it's only a matter of checking whether the actual time of change matches with what we have in this variable. And if it doesn't, that's time to load some external changes. But that's not all. Now that memory database is updated, we also have to notify all the scenes about that. That's clearly a task for a signal. Let's define an emitted. In the parent class, we are going to connect to it, but only if we are in editor, just to be on the safe side. And also only if it weren't previously connected, because apparently there is some sort of persistence of signal connection in tool mode, and after connecting once, it'll stay connected even after restart of the editor. We are going to connect straight into the function responsible for updating values of variables. That's it. Now we can make some changes externally and editor will catch it. But it doesn't work. Well, don't be scared, it actually works. It's just that UI apparently weren't prepared for such situations and it's not updated properly. All we have to do is deselect this node and select it again. Now UI elements are up to date, we can see that external changes took effect, and with that we are done for today. All the code presented in this video is available on GitHub, you can find a link to it in the description, same as with some other helpful links and my socials where I post a bit more about the projects I'm working on. There is still a few things left on the subject of central storage for export variables, like usage of config files, and creating an editor extension for this thing, which I might make a video about in the future. But for now I hope that this video was helpful for you and really want to know your opinion on it. So leave comments down below, consider subscribing and ring the bell to not miss the next part. Thanks for watching, see you next time, stay safe, have a good day and bye.